Welcome back. Today we're going to look at lesson 8, and our today topic is still on limited liability company. If you remember, in our last class we looked at what a limited liability company is, we looked at the definition of a limited liability company and the characteristics of a limited liability company. And if you do remember, we did say limited liability company are two. It can be public limited liability company and private limited liability company. So today we are going to look at what formation of a company. How do you form a company? How do you establish a company? How do you create a company? So before that, let's look at formation of a company is a legal process and action put in place in establishing a company with judicial or court implication. What do we mean by judicial or court implication here? Meaning there must be the rights and the duties. It must be clearly spelled out. It must have a what? Court implication in the case of default. Even the signing of the document, there must be what? It must be properly documented. There must be a legal document backing it. There must be a legal act backing it up. And that is why you have the company, corporate affair company, and the CAC. Okay? So it's not that you're dealing in a business in isolation or someone will just defraud you. So it's very important as a commercial student for you to know all this. So now let's look at the legal requirement for the formation of a company. Okay, one, getting the promoters. Who are the promoters? The promoters here are the pioneer. They are the set of individuals that nurses the idea of forming a company. Okay, then two, fill and file the undermentioned document. You have to fill and file. That is, the promoters here or the pioneers have to fill and file the necessary document. They have to file it with the CAC, and they also have to keep it for record purpose. So what are the documents here? Memorandum of association, article of association, statement of nominal account is very, very important. Why forming a company? This document, it has to be filled and filed. Then three, the documents are stamped and lodged with the registrar of companies. Okay, the registrar of company would file and stamp the company to accept it if all the rules are okay. Then four, obtaining certificate of incorporation. Okay, when all the rules, all the guidelines stated or stipulated as per requirement for the formation of a company is okay, is being met, then there is need to issue out a certificate of incorporation. Then five, obtaining certificate of trading. So these are the legal requirements for the formation of a company. Now, before we look at this item after the other, there is need for you to look at the concepts, these concepts in the forming of a company. Who are the promoters? From here you can see, promoters are a group of individuals that nurses the idea of establishing a company and follows the necessary legal procedure to its formation. Okay? Then memorandum of association. A memorandum of association is a document that states clearly the relationship between the company and the outside world. The name, as in the name of the company, the location of the registered office and their branches, the object of the, what is object, that is what the business or the company is into, what she intends providing the service or the goods she intends selling, that is the object, then etc. etc. of the company. So it's stated in the memorandum of association. So your memorandum of association is just a document between the company and the external world or the outside world. Okay, it states the rules and the regulation. Okay, now let's look at the article of association. Article of association is also a document laying down the internal rules and regulation governing the organization and management of a company. So how a company is going to be organized, how it's going to be managed, the planning, everything must be clearly written in the article of association. So it governs the internal regulation of the company. It's seen in what? In the articles of association. Now, what is a prospectus? A prospectus, it is a document of notice, circular, advertisement, or other invitation offering to the public for subscription or purchase of share or the ventures of a company. That is what's called a prospectus. It's like a form of notice, a circular, informing the general public about a particular share, which is normally carried out by a public company. Okay? The statement of nominal capital. This shows the amount of registered capital, which is the authorized capital, the maximum amount of money in which the company can raise from the general public. Okay? It has a limit of money in which a company can raise from the general public, and the manner of its distribution into shares. Okay? Then certificate of incorporation. It is a certificate issued by the Registrar of Corporate Affairs Commission of Companies that a company is licensed to carry out trading activities and the business is now having an identity separate from that of its own. So the reason why we have it here, carried out a trading activity, is that at this point, when a certificate of incorporation is being issued to a company, the company can carry out her trading activities. It's only applicable to a private company. Once a private company has a certificate of incorporation, she can begin trading. But for that of a public company, she has to wait for what? For certificate of trading. So that is the difference. So a private company, remember, I did say limited liability company are of two types, private limited company and public limited company. So a private limited company will only need a certificate of incorporation for her to what? To start trading. So in this sense, the company is now separate from the owners. It's now separate from the promoters. Remember, the owner of the companies are the shareholders. Okay? Now, certificate of trading. This is a certificate issued to a public company. To a public company by registrar of companies to commence business and exercise borrowing powers. So this certificate is required, is mandatory for a public company to have this certificate. Okay? So now on the writing, this is the act of some persons, banks, insurance company, or other finance houses agreeing to take the whole or parts or portion of shares of a company offered to the public and we're not taking up. So if you have a share that is being subscribed to, that is issued to the general public for subscription, and the general public is not able to fully subscribe for the total amount of that shares, the remaining part or portion will be undertaken by who? By banks or insurance company. Or if you don't want to face the stress of doing that yourself or the company doing that, you can assign the responsibility to a what? To an underwriting. The banks or the insurance company to do that. Okay? So these are the terms that is very, very important for you to know as the class progress. So before I leave you, I have this assignment for you. Outline the document involved in the formation of a company. Outline the document involved in the formation of a company. Thank you very much. So you can WhatsApp me through this number, 08035801104. Malan Nasir Muhammad from Sheikh Abubakar Rumi is the name. So thank you very much for your attention. Please stay safe and stay healthy. Bye-bye.